What's up, everyone? We're back for another manga review after all this time. Yes, I know. And it's been a hot minute, but I've been reading a lot. In case you can't tell, I still got a lot more I gotta go through. I gotta go through the bottom shelf right there. I gotta go through all these light novels here, and there's still more up there with Cursed Pikachu. Cursed Pikachu says hello. But from here on out, we're gonna be, in this video, talking about Otherworldly Izekiya Nobu, or Izekiya Nobu. There's multiple names for it. But basically, the premise is these two people opening up, Shinobu and then Yazawa Nobuyuki, the owner of the establishment. They open up an izekiya for the first time, and on opening day, they're like, all right, let's, and it's in like 14th, 15th century Germany, where glass is a rarity and like a very expensive commodity. So is clear ale and a bunch of other stuff. And they're very like accurate with it, with what they're talking about in the world. So basically what happens is you see the tendons come in. It starts with just the guards, and it slowly builds up as royalty finds out about it and hears about these amazing food, and it goes about all the politics in the world. It even sits down. There's a couple arcs where royalty, like royals, come in here and talk about what's going on in their nation, so on and so forth, as they eat and drink and enjoy the beautiful food that they have to offer. But at the same time, there's also trade guilds that come in. The leaders of the trade guilds come in. They talk about, well, you know, we can't do anything with this product. But the chef's like, I gotcha. Let me show you these variety of dishes. And they go and do all that. And then they turns the trade around for the city and starts making... They unknowingly help the city a lot by making different dishes and offering different services. And one of the things that I really like is that it also got an anime adaptation, and it was like 24 episodes. I think it went to like the third or fourth volume, if I remember correctly. But at the time, I didn't know this. I just watched it and I was like, you know, this is cool. I like it. They're like 11 minute episodes, nothing too crazy. And some of the episodes, they teach you how to cook some of the stuff. And from there, it's kind of, you know, just, it's a good anime. But I didn't know it had a manga adaptation until a couple, like a month or two ago, around Christmas time, or like right before Christmas, when me and N12 were on our podcast doing our thing, and when I discovered that it existed. So I ordered 1 through 7 in a blink of an eye. And let me tell you, the art in the manga is beautiful. I love how well illustrated it is and how clean it is. It's, to my tasting, very perfectly. They hit the characters very well with the art style I really love. They also hit the food with some good art style as well. It makes it look real, like realistic, like really realistic. And it keeps you on your toes, as well as, you know, giving out the perfect emotion of the characters and so on and so forth. So I personally believe the manga is really good. And I like the quality of the manga itself too. It's a, it's high quality. It's done by Udon Entertainment, which... they only do a couple of manga right now, which includes Persona 4, Persona 5, Persona 3, and Izekiya Nobu, which is amazing. And the quality of the paper is very good. The cover itself is very high quality. It's honestly one of the best quality mangas I personally have in my collection. And I have a wide variety, as you can see, and like it continues towards the wall. I have a lot of manga. To say the least, it's honestly one of my favorite mangas that I have. It's very wholesome. There's nothing too crazy. There is some drama, which, you know, keeps it going. And, like, there's a noble or, like, an aide to a noble. I really don't know how to describe that jerk. But he's just trying to put these people away. Like, hey, you're trash. You're not supposed to be doing this. You're all fakes. You're all, you know... you're scum, you're breaking the law, blah, blah, blah. He spreads all these rumors. But, and you see the locals and the, like, you know, the, what is it? The, what's the term I'm looking for? Regulars come together and, like, help Izekiya Nobu to stay there because, like, this is the best place to get food. This is where we're making friends. This is where we all come together to de-stress, vent about people, get our trades done, have meetings. And it's just, it's beautiful. And in the end of the quick note on Volume 7, at the end of it, there's like this huge festival, and there's lots of royalty. And you just see old customers coming back. And then the person who throws on the festival is like, why are all these people here? And then one of the other people is like, this is a place where we all come together. This is one of the best, wholesome, loving places we have ever been to with some of the best food. And they care for us as people, not just money. And it's just like, it's just so nice and wholesome together. I really enjoy it. If you want something different, and it's like just about food and like politics and just happy atmosphere, go for it. They also teach you some German words in the process, because it's 14th, 15th century Germany. So they teach you different words, and, you know, and they also describe what, you know, tell you about what the Japanese words are in here for the different dishes. And if you go and watch the anime, which this is the manga review, but if you go watch the anime, they'll teach you how to make some dishes, like I said before. But just based off quality and art style and everything else they have going on here, it's really well done. And the translation company did really well bringing it over. Now, if you're wondering what the price is, it's at $12.99, so $13 a pop. Which, honestly, for me, it's worth it. If you go to Right Stuff, you can get it a little bit cheaper. If you go to Amazon, you might be able to get it a little cheaper. The problem that I came across was Amazon was only had Volume 1. Right Stuff was out of Volume 1. But they had 2 through 7. So, you might have to order from different places. But if so, that's fine. I just really recommend you pick this up. It's very wholesome, very good. And, yeah, I highly recommend it. So, if you want to know more about this, because like I said, includes for everyone from royalty to like low level royalty, high level royalty, priests, city guards, all that stuff. It's wholesome. And it follows our two main characters, Yazawa Nobuyuki and Shinobu, which I don't remember her first name. I think it's Senkei Shinobu. Basically, they come from the same old restaurant, which they haven't really described, but they really did. And I don't want to get in too much spoil territory, but basically, Yazawa left his former employee and his to like go cook for himself, and you know, he's just, you know, he wants to find his own cooking and he wants to learn about himself. He tells people often to call him Taisho. So you'll throughout the manga, you'll see Taisho. You don't see Yazawa or Nobuyuki or anything. It's going to be Taisho. And then Shinobu, who is known as the harem princess, I think is what they used to call her or something. She's basically the daughter of the old restaurant owner and ran away from an arranged marriage. So like that, but you don't find out till later. If you're just curious on what this is about, that's what's behind it. That's how they get going. But it's a beautiful romance. No, not even a romance. It's a beautiful partnership. That's more of a perfect term. They're good cohesion working partnership. I don't think there's ever going to be anything out of it, but I'm kind of okay. But anywho, let me know what you guys think about this manga. If you want me to do anime review on it, I'll gladly do it. Just let me know in the comments below. But yes, we're back. I got like a couple more manga I got to do videos on. I'm doing them now, knocking them out, getting it done and over. So until next time, guys, I will catch you guys later.